summary, so the deputy president is completely innocent of all the corruption allegations against him.
And clean.
And clean.
It is not in my place. That you'll have to take. I don't know whether Harry you filed or Robert Arai.
You know, sometimes it's good to speak from the government and say all about these things. Because, you know, the land in question at Wilson Airport is government land. The last time, part of the hotel was claiming the land to build a parking. And, you know, children ended up being tear gassed there. Mm-hmm. And one of the children tear gassed is still in hospital because of asthma, in and out of hospital, out of asthma. The last week, I think she was fundraising or something like that. And it's very wrong for the deputy president to continue keeping quiet about, you know, I'm not saying that he resigned immediately. What I'm saying is that as long as the deputy president is keeping quiet about Western, about Eastern, because Eastern is Kenya Railways land. Mm-hmm. Nobody's wrong about it. The fact that it's Eastern and this is Western, people already connect that we know that he owns that and then.
But Jeff, what if the converse is true that for a lie repeated several times, some people want it to be true. So because no evidence has surfaced in many of these corrupt allegations, what if somebody is generally just trying to paint the deputy president in bad light?
Has Robert Alai or Rally Madowo or Jeff Koinange for that matter or anyone else watching filed any report on corruption or complained about that area? And Alai seems to have what he's calling, he's not even saying it's an allegation. He's actually speaking, to him, he's speaking the truth.
Yes.
If he has that truth, why hasn't he filed even private prosecution in court against the deputy president? I mean, we have lot of people talking, and I do not want to spend the rest of my time on national TV discussing the deputy president. Let's discuss corruption from a very wide angle. Mm-hmm. And I started giving you that back.
Without mentioning names.
No, you can mention names if you want, if you feel you have the evidence, and after this, provide them, or go and file for a private prosecution.
And I will be putting a disclaimer on all of
yes,
this,
yes,
because I know what it's like to be a guest of the state.
You don't want a repeat of
no,
that.
No. I think the best thing for me, for this government, is that for the government to be clean, because you know the issue of corruption and the issue of tribalism have to be addressed. But the fact is, as long as we have the deputy president accused of this, if today you remove Kimemias, the small Kimemias, Kimemias is not the deputy president, PS, you remove Kenya, you remove Chirkiri, you remove whoever from the ministries, they'll ask. You heard the stories from Gilu. Mm-hmm. Gilu was asking, where is number two?
Yeah. They're all pointing figures.
These are cabinet secretaries.
We're not discussing stories,
okay.
Allegations.
Okay.
Can we discuss
the issue,
facts? Can you give us documents?
So the issue
without
is,
documents, we are just alleging.
Okay,
something.
Dennis, any arrest?
He's mentioned Rangata Primary before
yes.
We go to that.
Okay, go on.
It was big coverage, tear gassing of children, and rightly so. We even moved NYS and did all that land. But has Robert Alai or the media itself gone back to court where there is a case about that land, where Airport View, who are the legitimate owners or claim to be the legitimate
who is
owners,
who is Airport View?
I mean,
sings, imaginary sings.
No.